Good morning, my dear students. Myself Navneet Kaur, and I'm going to teach you English literature in your 7th class. And today, let's start with chapter number 3 of your novel, Around the World in 80 Days. So, the heading of the chapter is A Dangerous Forest. So, Phileas Fogg and Passepartout sat in an old train that was rattled through the night to Calcutta. Rattle means sharp knocking sound of trains. They rode in the same carriage with Mr. Francis, Sir Sam Francis Cromarty. He was a fellow passenger of Fogg from Mongolia also. Mongolia he travelled with him. Sir Francis was a gentleman about 50 years and he is having a red cheeks and a big mustache, white mustaches. He lived in India for many years and was on his way to Benares. Fogg told Cromarty all about his bet around the tip of the world. Gentleman thought the whole thing was very exciting and he know a lot about the country, its customs, and Fogg found this interesting and useful. Fogg get knowledge from Sir Cromarty about his journey related to at present where he was in India. So what said Mr. Fogg, "You are lucky. This railway line was completed only a few weeks." And later he said that traveling without any problem until the morning of second day, it's easy for you to complete your way. So immediately what happened, that conductor announced, "Passengers will get out here." Francis turned to conductor in surprise. "What do you mean?" He said that line ends here. "Oh no," he said, "that was in newspaper, it was published that this railway line is completed." "Sir, that was wrong. All passengers know they must find their own way from Khalvi to Allahabad. From there, they can catch the train next to Calcutta." Three men got off from the train and walked towards the village. Cromarty said that, "Now, what we are going to do now?" Fogg was a man who would not let anything get his way. He smiled and said, "My dear Sir Francis, I started this journey only to face the challenges. Calm down, there will be a way out." Passepartout then noticed a man riding an elephant and pointed him to the Fogg. Fogg immediately walked up to him. He wanted to buy the elephant. He said that, "I will give you £2,000. Passepartout and Cromarty shocked with the reaction of Fogg. He said that, "There is no need to buy an elephant. It's too costly. It's just a madness." Fogg took no notice of their talking and gave the money to man, and that man happily took the money. Another young man standing nearby heard their conversation. Up to here we get knowledge about that their train stopped on the way and they noticed an elephant and Fogg by that elephant. So here their further journey starts on an elephant. All men together sit on the back of an elephant. They started their journey through the forest. And the guide said that, "I know a quicker ways. It will cut 20 miles out of our journey." Fogg agreed that idea and they travelled on until nightfall. But they stopped to rest until the next day. When they stopped for their rest and sleeping, Passepartout shivered with fear as others were sleeping, because it was an area of like a jungle. They feel very afraid from the sound. He feel very afraid from the sounds of insects, tiger, snakes. Buzzing sound of insect, growling of lion or tiger, hissing of a snake. But watching his master sleeping like a baby, he made himself safe also, and he slept. After that, what happened? They started their journey at the dawn. Dawn means early time before sunrise. So they continued their journey, and a guide told them that go away from the villagers. It is unsafe for them when we meet villagers. So in order to want to be safe, we must stay away from the villagers. They continued their journey without any problem. But only after 4 miles from Allahabad, they suddenly heard the strange sounds coming near through the trees. Elephant was frightened and would not go further. He met Kotoff and guide tied him, that elephant, to the tree. Carefully, they crept behind some bushes and until they could see what was happening. Crept means move carefully, avoiding any type of noise to be heard by anyone else. They all feel afraid and they hide behind the trees. Sounds become louder and louder. But that sounds come from what? It was a marching man playing a strange instruments. They were carrying a young Indian woman who was tied to a wooden platform on their shoulders. The young woman was next to a dead body covered by a large red cloth. But they are carrying a lady and a dead body of a man. By seeing this, Sir Francis Cromarty looked sad. A sati, a young guide nodded. Sati. So previously in video part 1 and 2, we just know about that their train stopped because there was no railways further, rail lining is stopped. So they stopped on their way, fog and precipitate out with Mr. Cromarty is with them. He's also their follower in the Mongolia ship also. Later they buy an elephant and start their journey. Rest for a night, and at the early dawn they started their journey. Continue their journey without any problem, but later they know some noises. That noises grew louder, and that noises are of a man marching, playing strange instruments, carrying a young Indian woman who was tied to a wooden platform on their shoulders with the dead body of her husband. So let us start in this video part 3. That what is that custom? Why that man marching, playing strange instruments, and carrying a young Indian woman who was tied to a wooden platform on their shoulders? So that custom is sati. A young guide nodded. What's that? Asked Fogg. In India, the dead are burnt, not buried. It is the custom here that the wife of a dead man is burnt with him as a gift to the gods. That's terrible, cried Passepartout. Sir Francis nodded and explained. Sacrifices are illegal in part of India controlled by English, but I'm afraid we have no power in this sewage, in this violent territory. Usually wives choose to die with their husband, but in this case, that lady don't want to die with husband. Fogg asked, what do you mean? He further said, everyone knows the woman's story. Her name is Odda. She's the daughter of a rich merchant, a well-known beauty with a British education. She got an education from a British institution and the daughter of a rich man. She was forcibly married to an old prince who died a few days ago. And the people probably kill her tomorrow morning as the part of funeral ceremony. Fogg walked away from men for a moment and he was in a deep thought. He suddenly feel very sad. He thought. And suddenly turned back to that other man. Gentlemen, we have 12 hours spare. He said that we have 12 more hours spare. Do you agree that we must help this poor woman? All said and shouted, yes, we definitely help that woman. But the guide looked worried because guide know the villagers are very bad people. He said that it will be dangerous. It is better to wait till nightfall. He said that it is better to wait till nightfall. Fogg calmly replied that we are in no hurry. We wait up to nightfall, but we must save that lady. So it's a Fogg's. Fogg wants to save that lady. He was influenced by that incident, so he wants to save the lady because it was not a good happen to that lady. So this is all in Chapter number 3. If you have any problem, please further ask me. Thank you.